Right, okay. Hi, this is John Blyler, Chief Content Officer at Extension Media, and today I'm at the beautiful Imec campus in Leuven, Belgium, and I have the pleasure of talking to Liesbet Van der Perre.
Yes, thank you.
I won't say that again, but what's your title?
I'm the Wireless Program Director here in Imec, and I'm also part-time professor at the University of Leuven.
Smart gal. So I have a few real simple questions. You've talked about many things, but one in particular was the millimeter wave sensing.
Yeah.
And that's at, 79 gigahertz, right? Yeah. So why is that becoming important?
Well, we think that it's a great technology for doing motion sensing and also for doing a lot of safety systems and other systems. It opens new application because the high frequency, the millimeter waves, allows very good resolution, high precision. And so lots of application that could use this kind of precision and don't necessarily also can be served by cameras, for example, can be served by this kind of technology because you don't need to have visible light. You can go through fog, you can go through lots of circumstances in dark situations. So we think for motion sensing at high precision, it could be very good technology.
So what comes to mind, I remember the infrared, cars using infrared to try and spot, moving objects in front of them. But this might be an application. So what are some of the applications for this?
Well, I think it could be complementary to this. And for example, indeed, in the car situation or in transport system, can do detection of pedestrians. It can really help in avoiding lots of accidents with people involved. I think specifically, if you see a situation where sometimes infrared cannot work, radio waves are just a bit more versatile, so it could help a lot.
Some of the challenges must be things like power and perhaps cost.
Yeah, definitely. Of course, that is the major thing to solve. And there, the fact that today we can try to do this in pure vanilla digital CMOS can help a lot. So we are trying to work on solutions that can be done in CMOS. And that will allow, if we scale it well in big volumes, to be really low cost and low power and become a technology which is accessible for lots of people, lots of applications.
Fascinating. Very interesting. One of the things we had talked about at the dinner last night was the millimeter wave. Well, the interconnect issue. So apparently this works best if it's near the antenna.
Yeah.
And that brings up issues of perhaps maybe the 3D stacking that's eventually coming would be of assistance.
Yeah, definitely. One of the challenges we have with millimeter wave is that the losses on interconnects and on wires are very high. So you need to get everything as close to each other as possible. On the other hand, the good thing is that the antennas at these very high frequencies can be made very, very small. So you can really think of a system where the antenna and the chip are very highly integrated in a 3D fashion, or maybe even integrating chips with antennas on top of the chip. So we're exploring lots of these options, and it's going to give nice systems, we hope.
Fantastic. Thank you for taking the time.
Thank you.